Hi guys, I am Tejesh with another video on fun math. Today let's see some important points of a triangle. First, there are four standard points of a triangle. Those are centroid. Centroid is nothing but the intersecting point of medians. Medians means median is a line which passes through a point and the midpoint of its opposite side. Means if we take this triangle, D is the midpoint of B and C, and the opposite BC is opposite to A. The line passing through AD is called the median through A, and the meeting point of such medians is called a centroid. And circumcenter is nothing but the intersecting point of perpendicular bisectors. As the name tells, bisector means the line bisects a side, and perpendicular bisector means it will be perpendicular to that side. Means the perpendicular bisector to AC is nothing but it passes through the midpoint of BC, which is D. The perpendicular bisector of BC passes through the midpoint of BC, which is D, and is perpendicular to the side BC. Means it will not pass through the other vertex, but it will be perpendicular to BC. And the meeting point of such perpendicular bisectors is called circumcentre. Incentre is nothing but the meeting point of angular bisectors. As we discussed in previous video, angular bisector means it divides angle into two equal parts, and the intersecting point of such angular bisectors is called incentre. And the specialities of circumcentre and incentre is that circumcentre, if we draw a circle as circumcentre as the origin and any vertex of the triangle as a point on the circle, then the circle passes through all the vertices A, B and C. Means the circle with center as circumcenter and a point on that as any vertex of the triangle passes through all the vertices. And incenter, if you draw the circle same way, such that in incenter you should take somewhat different. In circumcenter we have touched vertices, right? But in incentre, if we touch incentre as the center and if we touch that circle to any one of the sides, it touches the remaining sides. Means it touches all the three sides. Next, orthocenter of a triangle. Orthocenter is nothing but the meeting point of altitudes. Altitude is nothing but, if we take altitude of A, it passes through A and will be perpendicular to the opposite side. Means it passes through A and will be perpendicular to the side BC. It is called orthocenter. Now let's see what are the coordinates of those points. First, the coordinates of circumcenter of the triangle with vertices x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3 is nothing but x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 and y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. And now let's see what are the coordinates of incircle. The coordinates of incircle, if the coordinates of the triangle are A x1 comma y1, B x2 comma y2 and C x3 comma y3, and the length BC, CA and AB are ABC respectively, then the coordinates of the incenter are nothing but AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 by A plus B plus C and AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C, where A means if we take A is the length of the side opposite to vertex A, and B is the length of the side opposite to vertex B, and C is the length of the side opposite to vertex C. And circumcenter, what will be the coordinates of circumcenter? Circumcenter is the center of the circle which passes through all the vertices. You can tell in this another way, right? Instead of telling as the meeting point of a particular bisector, you can tell that it is center of the circle passing through all the vertices of a triangle. It means that it will be equidistant from all the vertices. Means OA is equal to OB is equal to OC. If OA is the circumcenter of the triangle, A, B and C. And the coordinates of A, B and C are x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. If you find the distance using the distance formula, you'll get that x minus x1 square plus y minus y1 square is equal to x minus x2 square plus y minus y2 square is equal to x minus x3 square plus y minus y3 square. Then the coordinates of circumcenter or x, y are given by x1 sine 2a plus x2 sine 2b plus x3 sine 2c by sine 2a plus sine 2b plus sine 2c, comma y1 sine 2a plus y2 sine 2b plus y3 sine 2c by sine 2a plus sine 2b plus sine 2c, where A, B and C are the angles A and B and C. Angle A means it is the angle BAC and angle B means it is the angle ABC and the angle C is the angle BC and A. And now let's see what is orthocenter of the triangle. We know that orthocenter is nothing but the point of intersection of all the altitude. If A x1 y1, B x2 y2 and C x3 y3 are the coordinates or the coordinates of the vertices of triangle ABC, then the coordinates of the orthocenter are x1 tan A plus x2 tan B plus x3 tan C by tan A plus tan B plus tan C, comma y1 tan A plus y2 tan B plus y3 tan C by tan A plus tan B plus tan C, where A, B and C are the same angles as we discussed in circumcenter. And there are some important notes. Those are: the orthocenter of the right angle triangle is at the vertex forming the right angle triangle. Means if we take the right angle triangle ABC with right angle at B, then orthocenter of the triangle is nothing but the point B. And the next one is that orthocenter O dash and circumcenter O on the centroid G are collinear, and G divides O O dash in the ratio 2:1, means O dash G is to O G is equal to 2:1. And the circumcenter of the right triangle is the midpoint of the hypotenuse. The circumcenter of the right angle triangle is the midpoint of the hypotenuse. Okay, this note is very easy to understand. If I take a semicircle, in the semicircle, the angle in the semicircle is nothing but right angle. Means a right angle fits in a semicircle with center of the semicircle in the midpoint of the hypotenuse. Okay guys, now let's see a concept called 9-point circle of a triangle. It is a concept of a triangle based on its altitudes. First, let's start what is it. First, let there be a triangle with three sides, three vertices A, B and C, and let's combine them to form a triangle. Now, let the altitude through A be AD. AD be the altitude through A. And BE be the altitude through E. As you can see, BE is the altitude through B. If you observe carefully, this is at right angle. And let CF be the altitude through C. Now we have the three altitudes, and the point of intersection of those is the orthocenter O dash. Now, if I take the midpoints of AC, BC and AB, let the midpoint of BC, let the midpoint of BC be H, and the midpoint of AC be I, and the midpoint of AB be J. These are the midpoints of the sides. Now if I take midpoints of the line joining the orthocenter and the vertices of the triangle, means the midpoint of AO dash is K, and the midpoint of BO dash is L, and the midpoint of HO dash, the midpoint of CO dash is M. Now we got 13 points, right? And how is this related to the 9-point circle? Let's see how it is related. First, if we clear up these sides on the triangle, now we have all the 13 points. Those are A, B, C and O dash, and D, E, F, D, E, F, H, I, J and K, L, M. Now the 9-point circle means it passes through D, E, F, H, I, J and K, L, M. Okay. Now, if we take a circle which passes through the 3 points, let's take any 3 points, I, E and M. Now, if you observe carefully, this circle passes through all the other 6 points. This is called the 9-point circle. Okay guys, this is for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're not, comment down below why you haven't. If you have any doubts, comment down below. I'll answer them in the next video.